Good morning, my dear students. Today we are discussing about the fecus. So what is the feces and what is the fecal matter, and then what is the physical examination, what is the normal values. So now we discuss. So feces examination, it is a feces examination. So examination, average healthy adults defects from the 3 times per day to 3 times per week. So average healthy adults defecate the 3 times per day to 3 times per week. So minimum 3 times per day to 3 times per week adults defecate the fecal matter. So these stools tend to be soft, and as well as the it is a bulky on a diet. So bulky on a diet in the high in vegetables and as well as the small and dry on diet high in water. Vegetables and small and dry on a diet high in water. So high in the vegetable and small dry in high diet, high in meat and water. And then the 2/3 stool's weight is attributed the water. How much of water is presented? 2/3 stool weight is it containing the water. It containing the water content. And normal, it is the color is the, it is the normally brown color. It is normally brown color. And the next one, it is a still undetermined origin. And the next one, it is a still undetermined origin. And the next one, the order results from order results from indole and scatol, and produced by bacteria. This one is a produced by bacteria and tryptophan. Tryptophan is a amino acid. So this is about the examination. So average, how many times per day? 3 times per week. 3 times. This is a normal value. And the stool tends to the soft and bulky on the diet, and high in the vegetables and small in the meat. And then so 2/3 stool weight is the water, and contain the water. Normally is bold brown in color. And the next one is order results from the indole and scatol by the produced by the bacteria and tryptophan. So what is the feces composed of? What is the composition? So composition, the water residues of the indigestible material in food. And the next one, bile. It composed the bile. Bile means pigments, and as well as the salts also, pigments and salts. And the next one, it composed the intestinal secretions. And including mucus. And the next one, it is it contains the leukocytes. And the next one, epithelial cells, and the large number of bacterias. And it is a made how much of quantity means 1/3 one by third it contain the 1/3% of the total solid containing the bacteria, and the next one means 33% of weight of the dry weight of the bacteria is presented in their composition. And the next one, it containing the inorganic materials, how much? 10-20% is present in the inorganic materials like calcium, phosphate ions. And the next one, digested food, that is the only small quantity, digested food only small quantity is presented in the given fecal matter. So it is a composition of the fecus. And the next one, examination of the fecus. The next, normal values of the fecal examinations. So in here, this is the examination and it is the normal. So first one is a color, it is a brown color. And the next one, order. So order is the various with the pH stools, depends of various different types of orders are there with the pH, and it depends upon the bacterial formation and virus formation depends upon the bacteria and viral. So the order depends upon the bacteria and viral. And the consistency. So consistency, it is a plastic, not unusual. Plastic, not unusual to see seeds and vegetable skins, and soft and bulky. It is a soft and bulky vegetable diet and high meat diet also. And the next one, size and shape. So size and shape is a formed, depends upon the body. And the next one, grass blood is absent. And the next one, mucus is also absent, pus cells also absent. And parasites also absent. In the normal condition these are all absent. In case of these are presented in their fecal matter, that is abnormal condition. And fat is it is a colorless substances. And it is a natural fat, is a 18% of fat is presented, and fatty acids are presented, soaps also presented. And the next one, undigested. So known to small amount of food and meat fibers, starch and etc is presented in their undigested food. And any eggs are presented absent, these are absent. And yeast also absent. And leukocytes is also absent. So this is the normal values of the microscopic examinations, especially which examination, this is the microscopic examination and normal values. The next one, chemical examination, and here normal values. What is the normal values? So pH, what is the pH? So it is a neutral or weakly alkaline pH. And the next one, in adults, what about the pH in adults? 7.0 to 7.5. And the next one, in newborn baby it contains the 5.0 to 7.0, slightly acidic. And the next one, breastfed infants. So breastfed infants, it is a slightly acidic in nature. And any oculated blood is presented. Oculate blood. So it is the occlusal blade is a negative, means absent. And the next one, urobilinogen. How much of urobilinogen presented? Bilirubin means bilirubin converts to urobilinogen in the fecal matter and kidney also. So urobilinogen is presented 50 to 300 mg for 24 hours within one day. 350 to 300 mg is presented. And how much of nitrogen is presented? 1 to 2 grams per a day. And the next one, how much of bile is presented? So bile is it is the negative in adults, positive in the children. Negative in adults and positive in the children's. And trypsin, this amino acid, trypsin, the trypsin is a positive in the small amount of adults, greater amounts in the children. Small in the adults and high in the children's. So this is the microscopic examination and chemical examination of the chemical examination and normal values of the fecal matter. Then next we will discuss about the inspection of the fecus. So any inspection of fecus means which type of fecal matter is occur in our body, which type of diseases. Now we discuss. So inspection of fecus. So in here, first of all, it is a type of stool, and it is the likely reason. So means watery stool. Watery stool. So watery stool means diarrhea. Watery stool means diarrhea and large amount of mushy and large amount of mushy and foul smelling and grey stools. So that the floats in a water. So means this type of stool is known as it leads to the reason. What is the reason? So steratorrhea. And the next one. So little film and spherical masses. Spherical masses means it leads constipation. Means it is the constipation. And the next one, narrow ribbons. Narrow ribbons like stools are occur in our body is known as the obstructive jaundice occur. Rectal narrows and stricture due to the stricture it will narrow like stools are identified. And any clay colored stools means objective jaundice. And then reddish stool means blood from lower GIT tract. Blood from the lower GIT tract. So beats to the constipation occur with the reddish stool is occur in our body. So this with the reason. And the next one, black or tarry stool. Black artery stool. So it leads to the bleeding from the GIT tract. Which GIT? Upper GIT. So with the lower GIT is known as a reddish color. Black color means upper GIT. And the next one, it leads to the charcoal consumption and charcoal consumption. It formation the black color. and green stools occur in our body. So green stools, the green stools means ingestion of the spinach. Ingestion of spinach, presence of the bilirubin, bilirubin. So seen in the patients is the look like with the taking the antibodies, also taking antibodies also through the oral route. At that moment, green stools are occur. So this is the sometimes, and the parasites also. The parasites means parasitic infections, like what are they? Pinworms, hookworms, tapeworms. With the, these two, due to this, it leads to the parasitic stool. So this is the inspection of the fecal matter. This is the inspection of the fecal matter. So these are the color change depends upon the physical character, depends upon the chemical character, depends upon the infection of the fecus. So we are determining the different types of fecal matter. And drugs induced the color changes also. Sometimes drugs also induced. Drugs induced color changes. So what are they? Like black iron salts. Black iron salts and bismuth salts and charcoal. So the black color is produced from the iron salts, bismuth and charcoal. And green, so how to produce again with the which type of drugs? So calomel drugs and chloride drugs, and with the, these types of drugs are it leads to the green color, it forms the green color. And the next one, yellow color means with the senotonin, the ficus is converted into yellow color. And the next one, yellow to brown color means with the using of the senna, and this type of the the next one, pink to red to black means with the using of the anticoagulants. So anticoagulants, it converts to pink to red, red to black. So these types of drugs also converts some color changes in the fecal matter. So this is about the physical examination, chemical examination, composition and introduction of the fecal matter and inspection of the fecal matter. So if you have any doubts from this topic, tomorrow we will discuss. Thank you.